Hello, it's Lori Gunn here in my violin room, and I would like to show you my beginner lesson number 4. And what we're going to do today is we're going to get our bow warmed up, we're going to get our fingers warmed up, and then we're going to play a song called Walking in the Moonlight. And I even want to show you how to play it on the piano in case you have a keyboard at home. So let's get started. Make sure you have your very best bow hold. And what we're going to do is we're going to butterfly down and land right on the E string, and with our bows nice and straight, not crooked like this. Now, what can really help is if you have a little guy, oops, my hair's on it, a little guy like this, and you can clip him onto your bow. Watch this, clip him on there. And then I'm going to try to land with him right on my bow. There we go, right on the string. So let's try that together. We're going to put our bow down and up and down. Up and be very exact and try to land in the same place each time. Now let's try some seesaw. So what we're going to do is we're going to seesaw our bow to the next string. So we're going to go from the E string to the A string. And do you notice here my whole arm is going to move a little bit, even the upper part of my arm. Let's try that together. Let's go butterfly down, landing on the same spot, and seesaw and back. Good. And seesaw and back. We can even move this guy down a little bit and try it that way. That's a little bit more in the middle. Let's try that. So now I'm going to butterfly down. Oh yeah, that's nice. Now my arm is nice and square, and up and down and up. Now these two exercises do not make any sound, so you want to be sure to go very carefully from one string to the other. For this exercise, we don't want to go all the way over to the G string, just nice and close. All right, so we've got our bow warmed up. Let me take my friend and move him over here. And now let's warm up our fingers. So what I would like to do is to see if you can place your first finger on the E string and hold it there. Have your best form here. Then place your second finger on the A string. See how I'm doing that? It's on the different string. And then place your third finger on the D string, and then your fourth finger on the G string. Okay, I just moved my violin out so that you could see it closely, but you want to have good form here, and my thumb is nice and in a good position on the back side. So when we get all the fingers like that, what we want to try to do is to tap them each 4 times. So I'm going to try to tap my first finger, tap, 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 and then tap my second finger, tap, 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 and then my third finger, tap, 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 and my fourth finger, tap, 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 okay? So let's try that one more time. All right, I'm gonna shake my hand out. I'm gonna get my stop sign, put my first finger on the E string, my second finger on the A string, my third finger on the D string, and my fourth finger on the G string. Now, if you need to, you can bring your elbow underneath your violin a little bit to help with the position. Okay, now let's tap our first finger. Tap, 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 tap. Tap our second finger. Tap, 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 tap. Tap our third finger. Tap, 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 tap. And tap our fourth finger. Tap, 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 tap. Whew, now that was a great way to get your hands warmed up and ready to play. If you need a little more warming up with your fingers and you have a lot of energy, what you can do is you can do the opposite of that warm up. Here's what I mean. You can put your first finger on the G string, your second finger on the D string, your third finger on the A string, and your fourth finger on the E string. So I have everything in position. Once everything is in position, I'm going to tap each time four times. One, two, three, four. Tapping the third finger. One, two, three, four. And tapping the fourth finger. One, two, three, four. So those are two warm-ups. And maybe you've noticed, if you did both of them with me, that the second one is easier. It's much easier to put your fingers down first finger G string, second finger D string, third finger A string, fourth finger E string, than to have it the other way around. Okay, so the song we're going to play is Walking in the Moonlight, and it's a French tune, and it has two parts. The first part is walking through the moonlight, okay? So we play it on the E string, and we start with no fingers down. So it'll sound like this. Oh, oh, oh. Then put your first finger down. One, and then two, and then one. Okay, so that's the first part. Let's do that again. Maybe you'll join me again. So get your bow hold and your hand ready. Butterfly down to the E string, no fingers. Oh, oh, oh. Then put your first finger down, one. Second finger down, two. Then one. Great. The second part is oh, two, one, one, oh. So let's try that. Oh, two, one, one, oh. Excellent. Let's do the second part one more time to make sure you really have it. Have your instrument up. Carefully butterfly down to the E string with your bow, and oh, two, one, one, oh. Ha, this is great. Okay, let's put the two parts together. Let's go back to our beginning part. Bring your bow down, no fingers. Oh, oh, oh. One, two, one. Oh, two, one, one, oh. Very, very good. Now watch this. I wrote it out to show you the numbers of the fingers. So 0001. And here's a two, and the line underneath it means to use a little more bow. And then the one, to move your bow a little slower and longer. And then oh, two, one, one, oh, and this is a really long note. So let's try it with the music up, and get, that way you can play with the music or watch me or just listen and I will say the finger numbers. Let's play it one more time. Here we go. Oh, 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 one, two, one, oh, two, one, one, oh, and a long bow. Now the fun of this song is that you can play it on any string. So what I would like us to try right now is to play this song way over here on the G string, our lowest, thickest string. It will feel very thick under your fingertips. And And to get there, we can give a little tuck with our elbow, not too much, and put down your first finger and your second finger. And when we butterfly the bow down, it's going to be over here, and your arm's going to be a little bit up in the air. So let's try that now from the very beginning on the G string. Here we go. Oh, oh, oh. One, two, one. Oh, two, one, one, oh. Yeah, I hope you were able to do that. Now, the reason we moved it over to the G string, the song, is that if you can play it on the G string, it will be very fun for you to also play this song on the piano too. And I'm gonna show you. Now, I'm using my toy piano because if you don't have a big, big piano at your house, you could use a keyboard or even a toy piano for this. So one thing you need to know about the piano keyboard is that we have the groups of two black keys and three black keys. And what you need to know is where this song will start. So I'm going to tell you that this song will use the white keys, but you will use the black keys to find your starting note. So we have three keys here, which means in the middle, there's two white keys. And you want to start with the key that's to the left. Do you hear that? That note is a G, just like our G string. Let's see if it'll sound like that. Yeah, pretty close. So G, G, G. Now, the next note, when we put our first finger down, this note is actually an A, which is the next white key. So G, 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 A. And then when we put our second finger down here, G, 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 A, when we put the two down, that's actually a B. So you would play it like this. O, G, 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 A, B. And then we go back to the first finger, which is an A. Back to the G, which is our zero. Jump to the B, A, G. Okay, I'll show you one more time. So we have G, 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 A, B, A, G, A, B, B. Oh, I said the wrong thing. I'm sorry. G, B, A, G. Now the fun thing about the piano is wherever there's a group of three black keys, you can find and play this song. Like up here. Up here it's going to sound higher, but it will be the tune. Do you see if you can hear it? Well, the other night we had a full moon, and I think that they were saying on the news that it was even a pink moon. So I really got in the mood for this song, for the moonlight. But then I was thinking about in the moonlight, sometimes there's some creatures that howl in the moonlight. Oh! So I have worn my fuzzy outfit, and I have a fuzzy hat right here that I can wear. And I have a friend that I wanted you to meet, and whoops, I just bumped him, and he is very good at howling. Look at, he even has a setting here that says to howl. So I'm gonna turn him on, and I'm going to play the Walking in the Moonlight song on my friend here, and maybe you will play at home. So what I will do is I will say the fingers for you to play, and if you can play it on the G string, that will sound the best. So let's see what we got here. What's going on? Oh, no, that's not right. No, stop that now. Behave yourself. All right, here, let's hear. Okay, I think we've got it here, everybody. Let's give a try. All right. So, oh, behave yourself. Okay, here we go. We're going to go, oh, 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 one, two, one, oh, two, one, one, oh, ow, oh, 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 one, two, one, oh, two, one, one, ow. All right, you guys, thanks for joining me for today's lesson, and I'll see you again for the next one.